By using the
In this video, we will explain about the super model. Firstly, we need to check the input water TDS. I've just taken normal water and its TDS is, you can see, 126. Like this, you can check the input TDS level. I've filled water in this and after that we are checking the TDS. So approximately 130. Like this, you need to check the TDS level of the raw water which is coming from the tap when you are connecting to the water purifier. If you can see, this is the display of the super machine. You can see the status, service, help and settings. Along with this, in the status you can see RO pump, purified water quality, time, which you can adjust accordingly, and no mineral in water because right now it is not connected to the input. RO flow rate, it's zero because of the same cause, there is no input. So flow rate is zero, otherwise the flow rate will increase to 20. The balance filter life is 760 hours. So this is the standard balance life for the filters. After this, the filter will give the signal and the system will stop. Now I will just explain in detail about the purified water quality. When you touch this, you can see the three levels. One is no mineral, one is okay, and one is high impurities. So in no mineral, generally the TDS level of the water, if the output TDS level of the water is 0 to 50 ppm, then it's no mineral. If the output TDS is 50 to 250 ppm, then it's okay. The needle will show in the okay region. And when it's more than 250, then the needle will show in the high impurities area. So right now the purified water quality screen is highlighted, and when you're seeing the needle in the no mineral, like explained to you, the either the quality of the water output is under in between 0 to 50 ppm, or else the input is not there. Right now in this machine the input is not there. We are not connected this machine to any input, so it is showing in the no mineral content. But after the connection, if it is showing in no mineral content, so what you need to do is you need to increase the TDS level, by rotating anti-clockwise the NCV or the TDS controller valve. One thing you should keep in mind always after the installation of the machine, that it may be possible that, for example, if the output water is showing in okay, but gradually you can see, if you are seeing that it changes to no mineral, so it may be possibly because of some factors. For example, input water quality may degrade. It may be because of the municipality or borewell. So it may input water quality of borewell or the municipality may increase or decrease. So due to that, either that the needle will show in the no mineral or needle may show in the high mineral. Secondly, it may be possible RO membrane is deteriorating day by day. So because of that, the needle may come in the high impurities area also. Third, it may be possible that the TDS sensor which is installed inside this machine, it is giving reading not appropriate because due to multiple usage and connection with the multiple usage, it may be possible that there may be sediment of different impurities, or so these minerals may sediment into the sensor of the rods, two rod anode and cathode, and due to this may be possible that the output of the purified water quality signal is not showing very correct. So these may be the possible reasons. So if the input TDS level is decreasing and it's showing in the red no mineral area, so it may be possible that now what you need to do is you need to do the TDS level TDS adjustment through the help of needle control valve NCV, or which is generally called as TDS controller. Now if we want to change the TDS level of the output water, we need to increase the TDS level of the output water as discussed, because of some changes in the input water. What we need to do is we need to open this system front cover. For opening this front cover, there are four screws, 1, 2, 3 and four screws, which need to take it out. I've taken out previously only. After this, you need to take out this cover slowly. And this is the connection. So what you need to do is, you take out this connector, and after taking it out, keep this connector slowly, outer cover slowly aside. Now you can easily check the membrane area. Now I'm focusing on the needle control valve specially. This is called the needle control valve. What is the use of this needle control valve? I've told you previously also. This needle control valve or the TDS controller is a patented technology of Kent. So it retains the natural minerals. So now when we are discussing, now what we will do is, for increasing the TDS level, we need to do the adjustment in this TDS controller. This is the TDS controller. So the initial step is to turn this ring anti-clockwise like this, slowly. After turning this ring anti-clockwise, now with the help of a screwdriver, you need to rotate a little bit like this. I'm rotating. After rotation of this needle, what you need to do is, you need to take the output. You need to take out the output of the post carbon before entering into the tank. From here, you will take a glass and fill the water. After 3 minutes, you will check the quality of the output water or the TDS level of the output water from this output after 3 minutes of turning this needle. So when you will realize that this needle, the output of the TDS level is between 50 to 250. So what you will do is, again, place the connection appropriately and just close this entire system again. And then rotate this clockwise to again lock the TDS controller, so that there will be no further shifting of the any valve in the TDS controller. Fine. But after all the adjustment, if you still see that the output of the output from the post carbon is not under the prescribed limit, so what you need to do is again follow the same method. Open the ring, rotate it anti-clockwise more, then take the output of the water till the time you get the prescribed level. So this is the complete process, which may be done in 1, 2, or 3 times also. And after setting the TDS level to an appropriate area, you can see the green signal in your touch screen also. Now in second case, when you have placed, for example, I'm just taking a demo, when you have placed everything and after checking on the screen that still the needle is either in the red zone or either in the yellow zone, means no minerals or very high minerals, impurities, but you have checked that from the output of the post carbon that it is in the prescribed level, so it may be possible there may be impurities or some sediment in the TDS meter, which is pre-installed inside. So this is a TDS meter, you need to sensor. Take out a TDS sensor, which you need to take out from a clean cloth. You just clean the anode and cathode of so after rubbing from a clean cloth, you again reinstall it, place it back, again take the outer cover, do the connections. And after doing the connection, again output, now it will show in the green. If still it is not showing the green area and the output TDS you have measured from the TDS meter is okay, then there might be problem in the TDS sensor which is inside the machine. After you have rechecked that the position of the needle is in the green area, that is the purified water is coming, so you again reconnect. So again connect it finally back, place this black in the appropriate position so that there should be no shifting of the wires, and gently place the outer cover. Again place all the screws in the prescribed holes.